Terence Holohan, CEO of Resolute, and two of its other executives went to Bamako to hold discussions with mining and tax authorities. After being detained on Friday, their whereabouts and the reason for their detention is still unknown.
Local media said that the Malian authorities are accusing them of forging documents and destroying property. This has been denied by Resolute Mining. But up until now, there's been no official comment from the government about why this has happened. But it's coming at a context where there have been other arbitrary detentions of mining officials working with foreign companies.
Beverly Ocheng is a security analyst based in Dakar who specializes in global power competition in the Sahel region of Africa, including Mali.
One of the things that happened in September when another set of officials had been detained from a different company is that they were released days afterwards, after the government in Mali had an agreement with that company over the new mining regulation. These laws increased the military government's percentage stake in the sector by about 15%. So it's likely that this is just part of a tactic by the Malian military authorities.
After independence from France in 1960, the West African country has suffered droughts, rebellions, and 23 years of military dictatorship. Democratic elections began in 1992, but two coups in 2020 and 2021 overthrew the civilian government and Mali's ruling military junta took control. Because of this, aid from Europe was cut.
There have been concerns about the standard of living for many Malians, the fact that the cost of living has increased exponentially over the last 5 years under the military rulers. The closure of borders has had an impact on goods being able to come into the country and out.
Foreign companies will not be pushed out by the new restrictions in the short term, according to Beverly Ocheng. The long-term goal, though, she says, is nationalisation of the industry. And this is just a step towards that. Mihalo Skinal, SBS World News.